Hey guys, so today I'm going to be showing you how to create this look right here just using drugstore products. Hope you guys like it. See you in a bit. Now I'm going to use the Dual Action Clean and Clear Lotion to moisturize my dry skin. Next I'm going to be applying my L'Oreal Magic Perfecting Base, and this is a primer, and I'm going to be applying it with my e.l.f. Professional Foundation Brush. Next I'm going to be using my Garnier Skin Roller, and this is just to cover up my under eye circles. Then I'll just be patting that in with my So the foundation I'm going to be using is the CoverGirl Clean foundation for normal to dry skin, because I do have dry skin, and I'm going to be applying it with this Eco Tools buffing brush. And the cool thing about this brush is it comes in a package of four, and it comes with a concealer brush, a foundation brush, contouring, and blush. So it's a really good deal to just get all four of them. Just going to put a little on the back. Probably spilled out on me. And I'm going to just dot that onto my face. Now I'm just going to take the buffing brush and just pat it into the skin. Now I'm just going to use my hands to pat my face so that if there's any brush strokes or lines that you can see, then it'll just be blended in. Next I'm going to be using my hard candy glamoflauge concealer. Now this is heavy duty stuff, definitely long lasting. This is my favorite concealer. So I'm just going to be using that a little bit on my acne for my forehead. So I'm just going to be patting that into my skin and blending it evenly. Now, because I have really bad under eye bags still, I'm going to use my e.l.f. Tone Correcting Liquid Concealer. Now I'm going to be going back in with that same flat top Kabuki Eco Tools brush, and I'm just going to be using my CoverGirl Clean Normal to Dry Skin Pressed Powder, and I'm just going to be lightly buffing that into the skin. Next, I'm going to start redefining the eyebrows with this Milani eyebrow pencil. And the color for this is Natural Taupe. So I'm only going to be working this into the very bottom of my eyebrow just so that it has a clean, crisp line. I'm going to be doing that in small strokes. As you can see, that's a pretty intense line, but we're going to just blend that out a little bit. So then I'm going to be going in with my Salon Perfect Brow Defining Kit. Now I'm going to be taking the darker brown and the light brown with a really light hand, and I'm just going to be working that into the outer half of my eyebrow. And I forgot to mention that this dual-ended brush did come with the kit. Okay, then I'm going to go in with just the lighter shade in a very light hand, and I'm going to start working that into the inner part of the eyebrow. Now you want to make sure that when you're redefining your eyebrows, that inner portion is lighter than the outer portion. Otherwise, it's going to be too intense. Now I'm going to be taking the other side of the dual-ended brush, which is a spoolie, and I'm just going to use it to blend out the line that we made with the pencil, and also blend the shadows together. Now that I've blended that completely out, I'm just going to be setting my eyebrows with a clear brow gel, and I'm going to be using this one by e.l.f. Now I'm going to be working on the eyes. So usually I have my e.l.f. eyelash curler, and that one is actually my favorite, but at this time I'm not sure of the brand of this one, but just take a regular eyelash curler and go ahead and curl your lashes. Now this is optional, but I'm going to go in with my Revlon Luxurious Color eyeliner pencil, and I'm just going to slightly tightline my upper lash line.
What this does is it just fills in any gaps between your lashes, and it makes your eyelashes look really prominent and extra thick.
Now I'm going to go in with my Colossal Volume Express Waterproof Mascara by Maybelline, and I absolutely love this mascara. Ever since I got it, I use it every single day, always as a first coat. And the reason I do this is because it is waterproof, and so it makes my eyelashes stay curled. It holds the curl, and this doesn't clump the lashes, it doesn't extend the lashes. All it is literally just a coating. The very best first coat.
So as you can see, that just slightly coated my eyelashes and just made them perfect for the next coat.
As that is drying, because you don't want to apply mascara right after you already put one coat because then it'll just clump up, I'm just going to moisturize my lips with this EOS lip balm. Next, I'm going to apply my blush with the Ego Tools blush brush, and I'm just going to be using my e.l.f. blush in the color Tickled Pink. Now that the mascara has dried, I'm going to go in with the Falsies Big Eyes by Maybelline, and this is a dual-ended mascara for the lower lashes and the upper lashes. And what this formula tends to do is it tends to get thick really easily, and so here's a huge tip for the day. Take your mascara spoolie and get a tissue or a napkin and just wipe off the excess mascara. Now you might say that this is wasteful or pointless, but honestly it makes a huge difference because you don't need all of that going into one coat of mascara. And so doing this is just going to really just coat your lashes instead of clump them. Now while that coat is drying, I'm going to go ahead and contour my face. And I'm going to be using the Physicians Formula Bronzer, and I'm going to be applying that with, again, my Eco Tools contour brush. So I'm just going to be working that into the tip and just focusing on the hollow of my cheek. Now I'm going to be applying that to the jawline and down the neck and on my temples and slightly just on the sides of my nose. You don't have to be too precise with this. And now that that coat has dried, I'm going to go in with the Rocket by Maybelline, and this is again a waterproof mascara. And yes, it is kind of thick because I have had it for a while, so I'm going to be using the same technique, just wiping off all of this excess product. Your friends all plead for you. Now I'm just going to finish it off with the Color Rich Balm, and this is a L'Oreal lipstick in the color Caramel Comfort. And just to give my makeup a nice fresh look, this is again optional, but I'm going to be applying a makeup setting spray. The makeup setting spray I'm going to be using is the one by e.l.f. So I'm just going to spray about 3 mists all over my face.
So this is the finished makeup look. I hope you guys like it. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and go ahead and share it to your friends and make sure to subscribe to my channel. Okay? See you next time. Bye.
Where are you going?